All right, everyone, we're going to start. Welcome to the very first general body meeting of this academic year. I'd like to welcome back all of our returning members and new members, especially the class of 2023. Raise your hand. Class 20. Cool. Thanks for being here. All right, so just notification, you are being recorded. We have a camera right back there that Will is manning. And all of the recording slides from each meeting are available on our archive. It's at acm.uc.org/archive. And also, here it is on the board and on the slide. Please fill out the attendance. This is how you will be able to vote at the end of the year. So please do that. So what is ACM at UC? Well, you might have seen from our emails, we are the student chapter of the Association for Computing Machinery. We are the computer science and program community at UC. So we're just a group of students built around the same interest, which is computers, technology, and software. So we host talks, workshops, hackathons, programming contests, etc. And you can be any major to join ACM. CS, CE, EE, IT, IS, doesn't matter, all are welcome. So what is ACM? ACM is an international organization just for people interested in computing. So it advancing computing as a science and profession. So they provide a lot of resources for the international community, and as I said, we're a student chapter. So what exactly do we do? Well, we have bi-weekly meetings, you're in one right now. Where we do tech talks and workshops. We also hold social events, programming review sessions, programming contests like ICPC, tutoring and office hours. We host a hackathon, Revolution UC, and we also host Hack Days. We have some awesome resources out there, including our Slack community, which I'll give you the URL for later, recorded meeting minutes, which I touched on. We have a GitHub org, lots of stuff available. So what to expect this academic year? Well, as I mentioned, we have talks and workshops, hackathons. Here's some topics that you might see throughout the academic year. Git, reverse engineering, cybersecurity, iOS and Android development, low-level graphics, and OpenGL. So a lot of cool stuff here. And this list will definitely grow throughout the year. So the membership requirements for our student organization. You just have to attend two meetings in 2018-2019. That's it. You don't have to pay dues to ACM National, you just have to attend two meetings. And if you do attend two meetings, at the end of the year, you'll be able to vote in officer elections. So we do have a code of conduct. We're a student organization, so we're dedicated to a harassment-free experience for everyone. If you want to find more information, you can visit our website, acmuc.org/conduct. And of course, do also follow the UC code of conduct, and just be cool. So we do have some academic services, including programming review sessions. So these review core concepts of C++. And all of our past talks from these are on YouTube. So if you need help with a specific programming language, maybe C++, these are great. We also host office hours 2 times a week in our fishbowl area on Rhodes 802A. That's if you're in like the collaboration zone, you'll see a glass office. Glass on two sides, and there's a sign up there to let you know it's the ACM office. So it's Tuesdays 3 to 4, and then Wednesdays 6 to 7. So the International Collegiate Programming Contest, ICPC as it's known, you may have heard of this. It's an international contest, and we have a regional competition here at UC happening November 9th and 10th. So if you're interested in joining a team or volunteering, just contact me anytime on Slack or by email. The registration info is to be determined, but teams are a group of three. So this is a great opportunity to test your coding and algorithm skills. Revolution UC is our probably main headliner event of the academic year. It's a hackathon. And this spring will be its 8th iteration. We have hundreds of people show up for this awesome weekend, and it's 24 hours of free food, coding, learning, and fun. And we also have some sponsors and mini events that go along with the hackathon. So I just want to show you this video from our hackathon 2 years ago so you get a sense of what it's like.
We have a fantastic weekend lined up for you, and we can't wait to see what you're going to come up with.
Of Revolution UC, our student hackathon. Registration information for this will be coming either at the end of the semester or the very beginning of next semester. That is to be determined. But it will be returning in spring 2019. Now, we have a new opportunity here. We're calling it Make UC 2018. Make UC is a hackathon debuting September 29th. That's a Saturday. It's a community event for CSCE and EE students. So it's 12 hours where you can concentrate on software, hardware, or both. And we have some sponsors, including ACM at UC and the IEEE chapter at UC. So space is really limited for this. So if you're interested in doing this 12-hour hack day, you can register now at makeuc.io. Any questions about Revolution UC, Make UC, or hackathons in general, before I continue? Okay. Oh, yes, JT.
Do they cost money?
Good question. Hackathons do not cost money, no. They're free. And yes, there is free food. Okay. So our Slack workspace is definitely the best way to connect with other people in the student org. There's daily discussion. Links to cool stuff, job opportunities, et cetera. If you want to sign up for this, you can sign up at acmcincy.slack.com/signup. Super easy, just put in your UC email. It's totally free. You can introduce yourself in the intros thread that I set up. So just say your name, major, what you're interested in. We have a number of different channels to talk about stuff. And if there isn't a channel for what you want, go ahead and create it. Also, there's desktop and mobile apps available for this. And of course, the code of conduct applies because it is an ACM Slack channel. Other resources, the archive I mentioned earlier, acmuc.org/archive. Our listserv is where you get a lot of notifications about meetings. By checking into this meeting, you'll automatically be added to the listserv, so be sure to do that. And on YouTube, you can look us up, ACM at UC. This meeting will be on YouTube. So a little bit about me. My name is Noah. I'm a fourth year CS. I am the president of ACM at UC. My favorite language is JavaScript, and my favorite TV show is The Office. So we're going to go ahead and introduce the rest of exec. We have our vice president. Christian, you want to introduce yourself?
Hi, my name's Christian. I'm a fourth year CS student, currently in Ascend as well, doing the master's in CS program. And I'm your vice president and your chief waffle officer, or waffle sir.
Okay, thank you, Christian. We have Alex somewhere.
Hi, everyone. Over here. My name is Alex. I'm the treasurer on the second year computer science major. My favorite TV show would be Parks and Recreation.
Maddie.
Hello. I'm a third-year computer science student. I'm also a tour guide, and I help with Revolution UC. I love tacos, and I'm an iOS developer.
And we have Isaiah.
Hi, I'm Isaiah. I'm the webmaster, and I'm a third-year CS. There's my Twitter handle. You can follow me. Go follow me on there. Since we're with two favorite TV shows, I'll throw in Arrested Development in there. My favorite TV show.
And we have three committee chairs. One of them is not here and will not be here until the spring semester. He is on co-op. Corey is a third year CS. He lists his SoundCloud link down here as well. He wants to share that. So yeah, that's Corey. Will. Yeah. Introduce yourself.
I'm Will. I'm not fourth year, I'm a third year.
Oh, sorry. Cool. And then JT.
My name is JT. I am a third year computer engineering student. I'm a region public relations chair, and my favorite TV show is going to be Breaking Bad.
Cool. So these are your execs for 2018-2019. And of course, we're all here. We're very passionate about computer science and bettering the computer science community on campus. So I want to stop for a second and just ask, what do you all want to see this academic year? Specific talks, workshops, socials, buzzwords, anything. I'm going to open this document and you can just say whatever you want. Yeah?
You can have any, I guess, like meetings or something with, for like, workshops on people in the industry or companies or something like that.
Meeting
so
people.
So we kind of get like our heads around the big names in the business.
Okay, meeting people and companies.
Yeah.
Okay. Totally open. Yeah.
Maybe some game jams.
Game jams.
Yeah.
Is that how you spell that?
Game
development
jam.
Not playing video games.
Yeah.
Okay. Although we can do that too.
Playing video games.
Playing video games. Okay.
We should live stream big conferences like
that. Okay. Yeah, Nick.
I'm meeting with some of the graduate professors to come on the conference.
Okay. Yeah.
Virtual reality.
Virtual reality, okay. And like a talk, workshop kind of deal?
Anything.
Okay. Yeah.
Another one.
Big data, buzzwords, okay. Yeah.
Assembly language.
Anything else?
Blockchain.
More buzzwords.
Crypto.
Crypto? Oh no. Yeah, Dom.
OpenGL.
OpenGL.
Yeah. No,
it's
Vulcan's the next OpenGL.
Cybersecurity.
Cybersecurity. That's a good one. Yeah.
Accessibility.
Very good. Is that how you spell accessibility? Web standards. The best topic, yeah.
Deep learning.
Deep learning. Okay. That's cool.
Artificial intelligence.
Okay, AI. Anything else?
C.
C?
Just C.
Just C. Not C++. There cannot be C++ in that meeting. Okay.
Just stupid.
Yeah.
Technical interview prep.
Oh, that's a great one, yeah. Okay. Yeah, Nick.
Continuous integration.
CI/CD. Somebody say something over here.
Continuous integration.
No. Yeah.
Do you want to like AWS or like some kind of cloud managing software or something?
Yeah.
Version control systems?
Yeah. Maybe Git. Probably Git. And comparing?
Yeah.
Okay. Others? Yeah.
How to use the command line.
How to use the command line, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Tutorial on how to exit in.
I think that's so important, we should just do it right now. Yeah. Raspberry Pi talk? Just general? Okay. Raspberry. Yeah, Nick.
Docker.
Docker. / containers. Okay. More buzzwords? Yeah. Well, I think we have WebAssembly. Do we have? No, we have assembly language. That's different, isn't it? Okay. Anyone in the back? Yeah.
GitHub Pages.
GitHub Pages. Good one. Maybe making your own personal website? Yeah.
Automation.
Automation just in general?
Yep.
Okay. All right. This is a very good list. I can't see how we can cover everything in 2018, 2019, but it's a great list. Thank you all for your suggestions. Lots of great stuff. Okay, and if you forgot something and you remembered it later, you can just DM me at Noah on Slack or just send it over email. Also, if you're interested in leading a talk or a workshop, that's totally cool. We have students lead workshops all the time. Just DM me again on Slack, and I'd be happy to talk about it with you. So, we do have some upcoming meetings. Thursday, September 13th at 6:30, we'll have a joint meeting with ACMW, and our guest speaker will be HMB Software from Columbus, Ohio. And they'll be doing a talk on blockchain technology, which is super awesome. Blockchain is just more than cryptocurrencies, and they'll show you why and how. Then our next meeting after that will be the 27th. We'll have ICR Security, a local company, in to talk about reverse engineering and cybersecurity. I heard someone say cyber earlier, so I hope you're here. So two things to look forward there. And happening around EECS. EECS is the Department of Electrical Engineering and Computer Science. So if you're in CECS or E, you're in EECS. So as I said, ACM UC, we're September 13th, CRC 3210. ACMW will be CRC 3250 the 6th at 6:30. And IEEE will be CRC 3220 the 6th at 6:30. And we have a special presentation on a service opportunity from ACMW. So pay attention to Tessa and Ozzy.
Okay, so we're from ACMW, which is ACM, but specifically also with the Council on Women in Computing. So it's not just for women. As long as you support women in computing, you are more than welcome to come to any of our meetings. But let me ask a question. How many of you guys need community service hours for some sort of scholarship or something? All right, so like a very good amount of you guys. So one of the big things that ACMW does is our Bearcat Coders program. And what that is we go across the street to different high schools. So like one is like literally on campus. One is right across campus at Hughes High School. You literally just cross the street from McMicken. And we help in their technology classes. So anything from like an intro to technology and things like that, all the way to like more advanced programming topics. So we help in all of their classes, and they have classes like all throughout the day, so it's more than likely that you'll have like a block of free time in your schedule that matches up with that. So it's walking distance from campus, can be super flexible. We do ask that you do about an hour a week, which for Cincinnatus, you need 15 hours a semester. There's 15 hours in a 15 weeks in a semester, so if you go one hour a week, like that's all the volunteering you have to do. And it's directly linked up with Cincinnatus as well, so you don't have to do any extra like submitting of extra forms, things like that. And we have a big community of volunteers and things as well, so there's always support for things like that. So if that's something you're interested in, we do have our first meeting next week.
And some of the things that we'll be talking about in our meeting, like Dom asked for technical interview training, we'll be having that during the career fair. How to negotiate, Tessa will actually be leading a meeting on how to negotiate if you have multiple offers, or if you get that during the career fair. We have a couple technical talks coming up as well, kind of right before the hackathon, before Rev UC goes on. So we have a lot of different kinds of meetings this semester, so if you're interested, we're every other week that ACM is not. That makes sense. So we're next Thursday in CRC 3250, which is down the hall that way, 6:30. Do you guys have any questions for us? You don't have to be a female. Sorry, I have one time. You don't have to be a female to be involved. One of the biggest things that sprouted ACMW was that, as I'm sure many of you see, there are not many females in your computer science classes, in your computer engineering, in your coding classes. And if you do see them, a lot of them drop out throughout the semester. So we're here as male allies and female allies to be there to support our female counterparts, to help them succeed, to help everyone succeed in this field, because it's not easy, and everyone needs that support. So we're really here to show that support. And honestly, companies like that too. If you go to a company and say, I'm in an organization that supports women in computing, like computer science or women in computing, that says a huge thing about like your character, about what you value in an industry as well, and how our generation is moving towards seeing women in computer science. But yeah, questions?
What day is it?
Thursdays. So it's every other Thursday that ACM is not.
There'll be one next Thursday?
Yeah, there'll be one next Thursday. Exactly. Yep, exact same time. There'll be pizza as well, so just come for the food if not anything. But yeah, any other questions? Yeah.
Do you have any data showing like why women tend to drop out?
We do, and I can send that to you individually as well. It's from the university, and it's from our surveys, and we used to work with Google, and it's from their surveys as well.
Okay.
All right, cool. Thank you guys for your time. Thank you.
All right. Now we have another special presentation from Tessa.
Hi again. Okay, so there's ACMW, but there's also WIT. We're Women in Technology. We're more on like the IT side, but we're also, again, open to anyone. So we actually have a bunch of, like I know you were asking for like professional development, like companies coming in and talking about their co-op opportunities, internship opportunities. So we have all these different companies coming. Quadratech, if you're interested in going to their office, we are going to their office on September 12th. Otherwise, all of these other info sessions will have people coming to campus to talk to you guys about them. All of this information we send out in a weekly newsletter every Sunday night with like all sorts of opportunities. So that's why I really wanted to get up here and tell you guys about this, because if you can't come to any meetings, this newsletter is an awesome place to get lots of resources like scholarship information, volunteer information, information about all of these meetings. So if you join us on campus link, if you go to this bit.ly/witcampuslink and you sign up through that, you'll get our weekly emails. And we also have a group meet to, like as Monty was saying, like it's so important to have a community and feel like you're supported by the people around you. So if you're interested in that, something else you guys can get involved with. Also, it's a great place for leadership opportunities. Our entire exec board are graduating this year, so we need underclassmen. If that's something you're interested in, please let me know. You can see more information about that from the newsletters and on GroupMe. Anyone have any questions about that? Yeah.
What's TDC?
TDC, that's a great question. It's the Teachers Diaries College. It's like over by like law school, if you know where that is. By One Stop, yeah. It's that building over there. There are actually game jams through like the IT school in that building as well. So that's something you can look into if you're interested in game jams. I know those already exist too. Cool. Thank you guys.
All right, thank you again, Tessa. All right, so this is pretty much the end of today's meeting. So it's a chance to get to know ACM members, just hang out, grab some more pizza. What's your favorite language? Yeah.
I noticed that at the Make UC event, you said that there were some hardware hacks. Do you know what kind of hardware hacks are available?
Oh, Arduinos. Do you know more than me? And
yeah.
I want to talk.
So
thank you.
I'm the president of IEEE, and I just wanted to mention that at the event we'll be having like Arduino kits available. So if you're interested, you have a group of people. It has like all the stuff you'll ever need. So like sensors and motors, and then you like a remote in there and LEDs. So if you come to the event, you can grab one of those kits. Thought I'd send that information out there.
Yeah. So again, Make UC software and hardware, and you can sign up at makeuc.io. So yeah, grab some more pizza. I think that's about it. Our next meeting is 2 weeks from now. Same room, same time. You'll get an email notification about it. Thank you all for coming.